Okay, it's the morning mess here. Have you guys ever been caught up on Facebook, like maybe cheating or anything?
No, I've never been caught up cheating, period.
Really? Really? Well, we're going to do the staycation setup. Oh, yeah, me neither. We got to talk to Christine. She thinks her boyfriend Phillip is cheating after using his laptop. I guess, Christine, you came across something on his Facebook?
Well, yeah, so I was I've been doing a lot of schoolwork on my laptop because I'm back to school, but it's all online, you know, and I was at Phillip's place and my laptop died, so I needed to use his. Mm-hmm. And I grabbed it and I wasn't paying much attention. And I decided, like, because I was getting bored with my class, to go onto Facebook. And his was open, obviously, because it's his computer.
So, right.
So I was going to log into mine, but his was open. I wasn't looking.
Christine, how long is this story? Seriously.
I think she's really nervous that we think she's snooping. I promise we don't think you're snooping at all. It was totally accidental, but you stumbled onto something. Girl, what was it?
Snoop
Dogg. Yeah, he had a message. So I said, it was from a woman. It said, I told him that he had a message from this woman on Facebook, and he just snatched it away from me.
Oh. Wait, what? So he snatched it when you told him that he had a message?
Right.
Oh, did you catch the name?
It was someone named Lindsay. It was a woman.
Lindsay. You didn't catch the message?
I mean, I'm not trying to, you know, like...
Lindsay about to catch a fade.
No, don't say that. Okay, do you know who Lindsay is? Is this like a friend of his, a coworker or something?
No idea. Not a clue.
And he didn't offer up any explanation? He just snatched the computer and that was it?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Would he be a repeat offender? Has he ever cheated on you in a relationship where you caught him, or this is all new?
No, this is like a weird new thing. That's why I'm concerned about it.
Now, you are calling for the staycation setup, so we'd be calling him up and seeing who he picked for the romantic weekend stay. But I also want to point out, like, once we do that, like, there's no going back from it. Like, are you sure this is something you want to go through with?
Yes, 100%.
I'm here for it.
Okay.
Do they still have that poke feature on Facebook, or is that done?
I don't know.
I haven't been on in a while.
No.
Do you know if that poke feature is still on, Christine?
I have no idea. I haven't tried to use it.
Well, let's find out if Phillip's using it.
Oh, God.
Might be poking Lindsay. We're going to do the staycation setup up next, Morning Mess. Okay, your Morning Mess inside the staycation setup. Have you ever been caught up on Facebook? We're going to find out if Phillip has, because Christine, his girlfriend, called the show. She let us know. Just borrowing his laptop, you know, to do some extra work and stumbled across like Facebook. And Christine, he saw you on Facebook, snatched his laptop away from you, but not before you saw a little message coming in from him from a girl named Lindsay.
I did, yeah.
You didn't see what the message said, but you can tell that your boyfriend's a little nervous that you might see the message from her.
Yeah, he snatched it from me.
Outside of this, like, we were definitely a little confused about the fact that you've never heard about this woman before and you guys have never talked about it since.
Yeah, I have no idea who it would be.
Well, what we're going to do is the staycation set up. We are going to call your man, Phillip, off from a free romantic hotel stay and see who he wants to put on that reservation. Are we ready, Christine?
Yes, yes.
Okay, here we go.
Hello?
Hello, am I speaking with Phillip?
Yeah, this is... what's up?
Well, my name is Jonathan, Phillip. I hope I'm catching you at an okay time. So I'm actually here with the Aurora Hotel calling with some great news. You've been selected as the grand prize winner of our free romantic weekend giveaway. So we're going to put you up in our penthouse suite with the honeymoon package. I was actually calling just to confirm details, but I want to congratulate you on being our winner.
Yeah, that's weird. I haven't stayed in the hotel in like over a year, so I don't know how it'd be like in a contest.
I got you. So let me go ahead and break it down for you. We actually partnered up with Google and Yelp. So we got your information through their online databases. We wanted to offer this romantic weekend stay in exchange for reviews on those pages.
I mean, okay, but you don't need like any credit card information or anything like that, right? Because I'm not giving my information out.
That is correct. So unless you decide to get room service, we won't need that from you. I tell you what, we can go ahead and get started with the reservation just to show you that this truly is going to be a great experience for you, okay?
Okay.
Phillip, thank you so much. Now, with this romantic weekend stay, it's for you and a guest of honor. We start this off with a personalized note. It goes to your guest of honor, and it's from you. A great way for you to set the tone for the weekend. Now, I have a space in here for you to write whatever you'd like in that note. Just let me know when you're ready, and I'll jot that down.
Okay, just put, like, love you, princess.
Okay. That's very sweet. So my next question for you, Phillip, is who would you like to bring on this free romantic weekend stay? I need your guest of honor's full name for us to continue.
But Lindsay.
You, who the hell is Lindsay?
Wait, what's going on?
Hey, Phillip, we got to let you know, actually, you're live on the radio. We're the Morning Mess. It's your girl, Christine, on the line with us right now.
You love her? What are you talking about?
Wait, hold on. Wait, you don't even know the full story. Like,
what?
You're jumping to conclusion.
What story, Phillip? What's the story?
Dude, she's my cousin.
Oh!
It's not.
Taking your cousin to a hotel?
A romantic weekend stay. Like, I'm pretty sure I made... Did I not make that clear? It's a romantic weekend?
Yes.
Are you kidding? You don't even have cousins in the United States. Like, they don't even have names like Lindsay. I've been with you for a year. Why would you even do this?
You trying to give your cousin Muffin a concussion?
No.
I mean, that's what it sounds like. It's disgusting.
You're lying, Phillip. We know it.
I think I would have heard of a Lindsay.
Whatever. Okay, fine. Whatever. She's not my cousin. I'm with her, okay? It's not a big deal.
Hey, Phillip, who was better, Lindsay or Christine?
Christine.
Why the f*** would it take you that long to answer the question? Like, you absolutely are disgusting. Can you please hang up on him?
Okay. Phillip, are you still there?
Yeah.
I just want to make sure so I can hang up on you. Hold on.
Girl, I am so sorry. The cousin thing was so dumb.
I can't. He's an idiot. I can't.
So, girl, from this point now, what we can do is we can offer you some counseling services if that's what you're interested in. Is that something you'd like to pursue?
I'm good. I just want to forget about all this. It's ridiculous. It's disgusting.
Right. The best way to get over somebody is to get under somebody. You have someone in mind?
No, I don't at the moment. No.
Keep talking like that to me, girl.
No,
like,
no.
God.
I don't know. Her voice just got deeper.
Yeah, you know, that's okay.
Do you know that song by TLC? You sound like T-Boss.
What song?
Don't go chasing water. You sound just like her. Talk to me, Christine.
Okay. Why are you laughing, girl? This is getting really nasty.
Let me practice. My wife might be leaving me this week.
Joey.
Oh, my God. This is so weird.
I know.
Yeah, it is, girl.
Christine, what you doing later?
Oh, my God.
Girl, hold on one second. I'm going to save you. Hold on.
Cause I creep, yeah. Keep it on the down low.
Okay. The weirdest day.
The Morning Mess.
Now for free.